I'd like to dress up this report a little bit. I mean, so far we've got the name of the tag, and then we go straight into the data. I'm going to add one of the attributes called the descriptor. This is the tag attributes option here. I'm going to make some space for it first. I'll insert a column, and then I'll just put the list of descriptors. Now, descriptor is just one attribute. You can choose any of the tag attributes to insert here. This is just one example. So let me go ahead and first insert this. We'll insert a column, and I'll call this the descriptor column. But if I wanted to put zero or span or something else, I could do that. Now, like all the other functions, we start by putting the cursor where you want the output. You don't have to select the entire range. Just put it where the initial value should go. This is going to be our input range, so that looks good so far. I'll go ahead and choose from the pie menu. It's called Tag Attributes. From within Tag Attributes, I'll choose that set of tags. Those are my input tags. And for the attribute, I'll choose Descriptor. Now, this is a list of all the different attributes available. This should look familiar because if we look back here, these are all the different attributes that we saw in the PyPoint database. It's the same thing. It's the list of attributes that make up the definition of the tag. So that's what we're talking about here. So let me do this again. Our tag name here is going to be right over here. The attribute I'm going to choose is descriptor. And then the output cell, it's defaulting to where I originally selected, which is C5, which is fine here. I'll go ahead and say OK. And now we've got a list of attributes. OK, a couple of other things just to mention as you're trying to dress this up. The accuracy that you see displayed here is kind of, through the roof here. I mean, this is 4 decimal places. This is, 8 decimal places? It's kind of ridiculous. There are ways to control with what degree of accuracy you end up displaying this information. And that's something that's controlled within settings. So within settings, if I don't like this general number format, and the general number format is basically going to take whatever settings you've got in Excel for those rows and columns or for that cell. If I don't want to choose just general, I can specify whatever amount of accuracy I want. Now, if I know for a fact that this is within one decimal place, I'll just choose that. Now, remember, what I just did was I changed the setting for all the subsequent retrievals. Yeah, I'm not modifying single cells now. I'm changing a general setting in data link. So watch how this works. If I go into, let's say we'll go into this retrieval right here. I'll go ahead and modify this. When I go ahead and say OK, it retrieves all over again. And as you can see, now the retrieval is coming in with one decimal place. I'll do the same for this as well. Do current value. This should be referring to, this is cells B6 through B10, so it should affect all of those. There we go. So now, having changed the number format, my subsequent retrievals will all come up with one decimal place of accuracy.